हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस डिस्कस फ्यू इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फॉर नीट पीजी 2021 एग्जाम। दिस इज अ रिवीजन सेशन। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट साइन ऑफ शॉक। ऑप्शंस आर इंक्रीज हार्ट रेट, डिक्रीज ब्लड प्रेशर, नैरो पल्स प्रेशर एंड कोल्ड पेरिपरीज। द करेक्ट आंसर इज नैरो पल्स प्रेशर। नैरो पल्स प्रेशर इज द फर्स्ट साइन ऑफ शॉक। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज which is not a feature of SIRS, that is systemic inflammatory response syndrome. The options are temperature of more than 38 degrees Celsius, heart rate of less than 90, respiratory rate of more than 20, WBC count is more than 12,000. The correct answer is heart rate of less than 90. One of the feature of SIRS is heart rate of more than 90. It should be more than 90. I have discussed about SIRS in detail in my previous video. Next question is which type of pulse is seen in warm shock. Options are irregular, feeble, bounding pulse, no pulse. In this warm shock there is high cardiac output status, so the type of pulse seen is bounding type of pulse. Most common site of ectopic pancreas. Options are stomach, upper jejunum, duodenum, distal ileum. The correct answer is stomach. Which of the following causes distension of pancreatic duct? Options are IV glucagon, IV secretin, somatostatin analog, none of the above. The correct answer is IV secretin. During MRCP, we will use this IV secretin to dilate the duct. Next question is drug of choice for infected pancreatic necrosis. The options are third generation cephalosporin, carbapenems, metronidazole, piperacillin. The correct answer is carbapenems. In case of infected pancreatic necrosis, we should start IV antibiotics. Most common mutation seen in hereditary chronic pancreatitis. Options are CFTR, PRSS1, SMAD4, SPINK1. The correct answer is PRSS1. This is protease serine 1 gene. Protease serine 1 gene. It is located on chromosome 7. The next question is what is the Cleveland Clinic fecal incontinence score for complete anal incontinence? Options are 10, 15, 20, 25. The correct answer is the score of 20. The score for complete anal incontinence is 20, whereas for perfect continence, the score is 0. Which of the following is not included in the perineal body formation? Options are levator ani muscle, external anal sphincter, transverse perinei muscle, bulbous spongiosus. The correct answer is levator ani muscle. This is not included in the perineal body formation. Which of the following is the hallmark of ulcerative colitis? The options are proctitis, anal fissure, pseudopolyps, linear ulcer in the colon. The correct answer is proctitis. Next question is most common organism causing Crohn's colitis. The options are E. coli, Proteus, Klebsiella, Mycobacterium paratuberculosis. The correct answer is Mycobacterium paratuberculosis. This organism has been isolated in up to 65% of the cases. The preferred drug for second recurrence of Clostridium difficile colitis is metronidazole, vancomycin, ciprofloxacin, clindamycin. The correct answer is vancomycin. Chicago classification of esophageal motility disorder is based on. The options are esophageal transit scintigraphy, barium meal studies, high resolution manometry, esophageal motility testing. The correct answer is high resolution manometry. This Chicago classification is based on high resolution manometry. Which of the following is not the trigger for diffuse esophageal spasm? That is DES. Which of the following is not the trigger? Options are emotional stress, pyloric spasm, gallstones, pancreatitis. The correct answer is pyloric spasm. This is not the trigger for diffuse esophageal spasm. The patients of diffuse esophageal spasm usually presents with chest pain and dysphagia. Next question is, which of the following does not suggest hemoperitoneum? Options are Kehr's sign, Danforth's sign, Fothergill's sign and Cullen's sign. The correct answer is Fothergill's sign. This Fothergill's sign is usually seen in rectus muscle hematoma. Abdominal wall mass that doesn't cross midline remains palpable when rectus is contracted. This is seen in rectus muscle hematoma. What is the investigation of choice for screening the breast cancer in positive family history patients? Options are mammography, ultrasound, CT, MRI. The correct answer is MRI. What is the drug of choice for non-cyclical mastalgia? This non-cyclical mastalgia usually seen in perimenopausal women. What is the drug of choice? It is NSAID. Whereas for cyclical mastalgia, the drug of choice is oil of evening primrose. This is for cyclical mastalgia. Familial male breast cancer is associated with BRCA1, BRCA2, P53, all of the above. The correct answer is BRCA2, that is BRCA2. BRCA2 is located on chromosome 13q. Next question is, a 45-year-old female came to surgery OPD with pain and swelling in the breast. On examination, there is skin tethering and nipple retraction. Patient also gives history of road traffic accident in her car. What is the probable diagnosis? Options are traumatic fat necrosis, carcinoma of breast, hematoma of breast, phyllodes tumor. The correct answer is traumatic fat necrosis. In this question, there is history of trauma, that is RTA, but this is not diagnostic. We should do biopsy for the patient to confirm the diagnosis. Why this option is selected as answer? Because seat belt may transect or avulse the breast with a sudden deceleration injury. This is given in Bailey and Love textbook. Next question is, a 22-year-old boy, known case of Klinefelter syndrome, is suffering from gynecomastia. What is the treatment of choice? Mastectomy, testosterone administration, danazole, none of the above. The correct answer is testosterone administration. In this question, the patient is a known case of Klinefelter syndrome. He is suffering from gynecomastia. We can administrate testosterone. If after doing conservative management, it is still progressing, means we have to do surgery. If gynecomastia is progressing, we should do surgery. What are the options for surgeries? We can do local excision, or we can do liposuction, we can do subcutaneous mastectomy. Which hormone is responsible for ejection of milk from the breast? Options are prolactin, progesterone, estrogen, oxytocin. The correct answer is oxytocin. Oxytocin is responsible for ejection of milk, whereas for production and all, prolactin is the responsible hormone. Which of the following appear as hot spot in radionuclide scan? The options are pleomorphic adenoma, papillary cyst adenoma, lymphomatosum, myoepithelioma and lymphoma. The correct answer is papillary cyst adenoma, lymphomatosum. This is also called as Warthin's tumor. Metastatic salivary gland tumor is often derived from which of the following cancers? Options are breast cancer, cutaneous carcinoma of scalp, papillary thyroid cancer, small cell cancer of lung. The correct answer is cutaneous carcinoma of scalp. Which of the following can be used to identify the lobes of parotid gland on imaging? The options are facial nerve, superficial temporal artery, maxillary artery and retromandibular vein. The correct answer is retromandibular vein. Next question is, which of the following may be the only sign of blast lung injury? The options are progressive hypoxia, hemoptysis, severe dyspnea, petechia over the chest wall. The correct answer is progressive hypoxia. This can be the only sign of blast lung injury. Which of the following is not included in the big five of the personality traits? The correct answer is introversion. This big five includes five personality traits. One is openness, extraversion, neuroticism. Fourth one is agreeableness. Fifth one is conscientiousness. These are the big five of the personality traits. Next question is, what is the duration to diagnose dysthymia in children according to DSM-5? The correct answer is 1 year. The duration to diagnose dysthymia in children is 1 year, whereas for adults it is 2 year. Next question is, which of the following is not included in the stages of grief according to Kubler-Ross? The correct answer is resolution. This is not included in stages of grief. What are the five stages? First one is denial. Second one is anger. Then bargaining. Fourth one is depression. And fifth one is acceptance. Next question is, which of the following is not included in the adoption triad? The correct answer is sibling of the adopted child. This adoption triad includes birth parents, adopted child and adoptive parents. Next question is, which of the following is most common sleep complaint? The correct answer is insomnia. Next question is, what is the meaning of acrophobia? The correct answer is acrophobia means fear of height. Fear of strangers is called as xenophobia. This is fear of strangers, whereas fear of closed space is called as claustrophobia. Which of the following is not the example of specific learning disease? The correct answer is expressive speech disease. This is the example for communication disease. Communication disease. Which of the following is not a type of somatic delusion? The correct answer is Othello syndrome. Othello syndrome is a type of delusional jealousy. Type of delusional jealousy. In this, patient suspects a faithful partner. Next question is, which of the following is not commonly used as date rape drug? The correct answer is LSD. Other three drugs are used as date rape drug, whereas this LSD is most commonly used as rave drug. That is, it is used in night parties. One important point is flashback phenomena. Flashback phenomenon. This is seen with use of cannabis. Next question is, which of the following is not a disease of stage 4 NREM? The correct answer is bruxism. This is a disease of stage 2 NREM. Stage 2. In which stage of the sleep a person can have memory of dream? The correct answer is REM stage. Next question is, hysteria is seen in which stage of the psychosexual stages of development? The correct answer is phallic stage. There are five stages in psychosexual stages of development. First one is oral stage, second one is anal stage, third one is phallic stage, fourth one is latency stage, whereas fifth one is genital stage. Next question is, dream work includes all of the following except. The correct answer is introjection. It doesn't include introjection. There are five components. First one is condensation. Second one is displacement. Third one is symbolization. Fourth one is projection. Fifth one is representation. These are the five components included in dream work. Next question is, which of the following is not included in mature defense mechanism? The correct answer is reaction formation. This mature defense mechanism includes six components, that is mnemonic sahasa. S means suppression, A means anticipation, H means humor, A means asceticism, S means sublimation, and A means altruism. These are the six mature defense mechanism. Next question is, which of the following is not the example of neurotic defense mechanism? The correct answer is projection. Projection is not the example for neurotic defense mechanism. It is example for pathological defense mechanism. Pathological defense mechanism. One more example is denial. What are the other neurotic defense mechanism? We have displacement and undoing. Next question is, which of the following is a disorder of orgasm? The correct answer is premature ejaculation. Premature ejaculation is a disorder of orgasm. The drug of choice is SSRI. Next question is, which of the following is a REM stage sleep disorder? The correct answer is nightmares. Nightmares is a REM stage disorder. The rest examples are NREM stage disorders. Next question is, which of the following is not a cluster A personality? The correct answer is histrionic personality. This is cluster B. Next question is, normal healthy thinking includes all except. The correct answer is clarity. Normal healthy thinking doesn't include clarity. Which of the following is not a disorder of possession of thought? The correct answer is obsessive compulsive disorder. This is a disease of content of thought. Next question is, which type of hallucination is seen in cocaine abuse? The correct answer is tactile hallucination. Next question is, which of the following is not included in 4 A's of schizophrenia according to Eugene Bleuler? The correct answer is auditory hallucination. There are 4 A's of schizophrenia. One is autism, second one is ambivalency, third one is affective flattening, fourth one is association loss. That is loss of association. Next question is, which type of schizophrenia has worst prognosis? The correct answer is simple schizophrenia. In this simple schizophrenia, there are only negative symptoms. This catatonic schizophrenia has best prognosis. Catatonia means there is increased muscle tone at the rest. Next question is, what is the gold standard treatment for depression? The correct answer is cognitive behavioral therapy. What is the drug of choice for depression? It is SSRI. Next question is, which of the following is the most common extrapyramidal side effect of antipsychotics? The correct answer is akathisia. Akathisia means restlessness, like foot stamping when seated. What is the treatment for this akathisia? We can give propranolol. What is the most common site for angiofibroma? The correct answer is spinopalatine foramen. Next question is, which of the following is not included in the rule of 10 of glomus tumor? The correct answer is 10% asymptomatic. This rule of 10 means 10% of the cases are familial and multicentric and 10% are functional. Next question is, which of the following is not correct about the direction of nasolacrimal duct? The correct answer is medially. दिस नेजो लैक्रिमल डक्ट इज डायरेक्टेड डाउनवर्ड्स बैकवर्ड्स एंड लैटरली. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज पार्ट ऑफ द मिडल ईयर सराउंडिंग यूस्टेचियन ट्यूब इज कॉल्ड एज. द करेक्ट आंसर इज प्रोटिम्पैनम. Protympanum means part of middle ear surrounding the Eustachian tube opening. These parts are divided with respect to the level of ear ossicles. Epitympanum means above the level. Epitympanum is the widest part of the middle ear. It is about 6 mm. Mesotympanum is the narrowest part. It is about 2 mm. Whereas this hypotympanum is about 4 mm. Next question is, which layer of the tympanic membrane is absent in healed tympanic membrane? The correct answer is fibrous layer, that is middle layer of the tympanic membrane is absent in case of healed tympanic membrane. This fibrous layer is also absent in pars placida. What are the three layers of tympanic membrane? There is outer cuticular layer, middle fibrous layer and inner mucous layer. Next question is, which part of the incus is most commonly involved in necrosis? The correct answer is long process or lenticular process. This long process is involved most commonly because of tortuous arteries and there is no muscle attachment. So, there is less blood supply. Next question is, in which of the following condition sinodural angle becomes obtuse? The correct answer is CSOM. Normally, this sinodural angle will be acute, that means less than 90 degree. This sinodural angle is also called as Sitelli's angle. This angle is present between roof, that is dural plate and petrous bone. This is the angle between dural plate and petrous bone or sinus plate. This angle is normally acute angle, but there will be collection of pus in case of CSOM. So, the angle becomes obtuse. Next question is, damage to which part of the inner ear causes nystagmus and vertigo? The correct answer is semicircular canal. Any abnormality of this semicircular canal causes nystagmus and vertigo. Damage to this cochlea can cause deafness. Damage to this utricle and saccule can cause disturbance in the linear balance. So, it can lead to ataxia. Semicircular canal means this is the posterior part of vestibule. Any damage to semicircular canal can disturb the angular balance causing nystagmus and vertigo. Posterior superior part of external auditory canal is supplied by which of the following nerve? The correct answer is facial nerve. The external auditory canal is divided like this. This is posterior superior, anterior superior, anterior inferior and posterior inferior. The question asked here is posterior superior. This is supplied by facial nerve. Anterior superior part is supplied by trigeminal nerve. This anterior inferior part is supplied by vagus nerve. And this posterior inferior part is supplied by C3. Next question is, which part of the pinna is the most common site for master tenderness? The correct answer is simba concha. Next question is, what is the most common site for apple jelly nodule? The correct answer is helix. Next question is, what is the most common site for osteoma in ENT? The correct answer is frontal bone. Least common site is temporal bone. In this temporal one, what is the most common site? It is external auditory canal. Next question is, which of the following is most inappropriate statement regarding the keratosis obturans? The correct answer is, it affects old age. This keratosis obturans affects younger age group. Keratosis obturans can be associated with sinusitis or bronchiectasis. patient can present with acute severe pain or moderate conductive hearing loss. Usually this is bilateral condition and we can see circumferential bony erosion. In this, there won't be osteonecrosis. Osteonecrosis is not seen. There is one differential diagnosis, that is external ear canal cholesteatoma. External ear canal cholesteatoma. This is seen in elderly. There will be dull pain. There will be little or no hearing loss and bony erosion is localized. In this, osteonecrosis is usually present. Next question is, in which of the following condition Gerhardt notch is seen? The correct answer is otosclerosis. There is maximum hearing loss at 2000 Hz in bone conduction. Next question is, what is the investigation of choice for conductive deafness? The correct answer is tympanometry. This tympanometry depends on the air conduction compartment. So, any abnormalities in the tympanogram will be differential diagnosis for the conductive deafness. This electrocochleography is the investigation of choice in Meniere's disease. Meniere's disease, or this is also called as endolymphatic hydrops. Next question is, which of the following is not the hallmark feature of Meniere's disease? The correct answer is conductive deafness. The hallmark features of Meniere's disease are, the order of symptom is tinnitus, vertigo, and there will be sensory deafness. Along with this, there will be fullness of ear. Next question is, which of the following is not true about aticoantral CSOM? The correct answer is tympanoplasty is the treatment of choice. This is not correct. Tympanoplasty is done in safe CSOM, that is tubotympanic CSOM. In this aticoantral CSOM, this is also called as unsafe CSOM. In this, ossicles and tympanic membrane are fully eroded. The basic anatomy is distorted. We can see scanty discharge. It can involve attic antrum. It can also involve pars flaccida. There will be foul smelling discharge. So in this aticoantral CSOM, we will perform operation to reduce the complications. So here treatment is mastoidectomy. Next question is, what is the most common complication of tympanoplasty? The correct answer is residual perforation. Next question is, what is the most common intracranial complication of CSOM? The correct answer is meningitis. Meningitis is the most common intracranial complication of CSOM. This brain abscess is the second most common intracranial complication. Extradural abscess is the third most common complication. This mastoiditis is the most common extracranial complication. What is the most common complication of tracheostomy? The correct answer is hemorrhage. What is the most common organism causing epiglottitis? The correct answer is streptococcus. Epiglottitis is the emergency condition. Patient will be having high grade fever. And there will be inspiratory dyspnea and patient will be toxic. We should start IV antibiotics. Next question is, what is the most common site for congenital webs? The correct answer is anterior commissure. We can see congenital webs or syphilitic lesions or leprosy or lupus or papillomatosis on anterior commissure. Next question is, which of the following is the largest paranasal sinus? The correct answer is maxillary sinus. It has capacity around 15 ml. Next question is, which paranasal sinus starts to develop at last among the all paranasal sinuses? The correct answer is frontal sinus. Frontal sinus is the last sinus to develop. What is the investigation of choice in cases of sinusitis? The correct answer is endoscopy. Endoscopy is the investigation of choice and treatment of choice. X-ray is the first investigation to be done. HRCT is the radiological investigation of choice. Which of the following is the most common joint involved in gout? The correct answer is metatarsophalangeal joint. Gout can involve tendons, skin, bursa, but it does not involve muscle. Next question is, which of the following is not a feature of Erb's palsy? The correct answer is loss of pronation of forearm. This Erb's palsy is due to injury to brachial plexus. And there is loss of sensation over small area of lower deltoid. Next question is, which of the following is not a cause for recurrent patellar dislocation? The correct answer is large patella. The causes for recurrent patellar dislocation are excessive joint laxity, small patella, genu valgum. Treatment for this patellar dislocation is Fulkerson osteotomy. Fulkerson osteotomy. Next question is, what is the most common level of disc prolapse? The correct answer is L4, L5. L4, L5 is more common than L5, S1, which is more common than L3, L4. Next question is, which of the following is known as mature cells of bone? The correct answer is osteocytes. Osteocytes are also known as resting cells or mature cells of bone. Osteons are the structural and functional unit of bone. Structural and functional. Next question is, which of the following is an example for traction epiphysis? The correct answer is tuberosity of humerus. Example for traction epiphysis are tuberosities and trochanters. These are the examples for traction epiphysis. Head of femur is example for pressure epiphysis. This pressure epiphysis is the weight bearing part of body. Next question is, which part of bone is highly vascular? The correct answer is metaphysis. Metaphysis is a cancellous bone. It is spongy. Hairpin loop of vessels are present in the metaphysis. There is high chances of stagnation of blood, so it can lead to ischemia and it is the most common site for infection. Next question is, which of the following is the most metabolically active layer in the long bone? The correct answer is endosteum. Next question is, in which of the following bone ossification center is present at birth? The correct answer is talus. Ossification center is present at birth in cases of talus, calcaneum, distal femur and cuboid. In these bones, ossification centers are present at the time of birth. What is the most common fracture due to fall on outstretched hand in adults? The correct answer is fracture scaphoid. Fracture of scaphoid is the most common fracture due to fall on outstretched hand in adults. Supracondylar fracture of humerus is most common in children. This scolies fracture is most common in elderly age group. Next question is, which of the following is the most common joint to undergo dislocation? The correct answer is shoulder joint. Shoulder joint is the most common joint to undergo dislocation and it is also the most common joint to undergo recurrent dislocation. Knee joint is the least common joint to undergo dislocation. Which of the following is called as forgotten muscle of shoulder? The correct answer is subscapularis. These muscles are attached to greater tuberosity, whereas the subscapularis is attached to lesser tubercle. This subscapular is not attached to greater tubercle, that's why it is called as forgotten muscle of shoulder. Next question is, which of the following splint is used for brachial plexus palsy? The correct answer is aeroplane splint. This aluminium splint is used for phalangeal fracture. Dennis Brown is used for club foot. Taylor splint is used for thoracic spine. Next question is, in which of the following condition three bony point relationship is normal? The correct answer is supracondylar fracture of humerus. What is this three bony point relationship? It includes lateral condyle, medial condyle and olecranon process. These three bony points form triangle in flexion of elbow, whereas these bony points forms a single line in extension. In these cases, this three bony point relationship is altered, but in supracondylar fracture of humerus, this is normal. Next question is, which of the following is called as fracture of necessity in Salter-Harris classification of physial trauma? The correct answer is type 4. Type 4 means this is intra-articular fracture. There is rotation of distal fragment on its own axis. So, in this case, we need to do open reduction and internal fixation. That's why this is called as fracture of necessity. Examples for this fracture of necessity are lateral condylar fracture, Montegia fracture, Galicia fracture. Next question is, which of the following is the most common fracture in children around elbow? The correct answer is supracondylar fracture of humerus. Next question is, which of the following joint is most commonly involved in myositis ossificans? The correct answer is elbow joint. Myositis ossificans means there is ectopic benign pathological bone formation. It is usually due to passive manipulation or massage or due to stretching exercises. Next question is, which of the following is the most common complication of fracture of lateral condyle of humerus? The correct answer is lateral bony spur formation. Most common complication requiring surgery is non-union. This non-union causes cubitus valgus, this requires surgery. This is dynamic and functional deformity. Next question is, which of the following is not a component of terrible triad? The correct answer is anterior dislocation of elbow. This is not included. This terrible triad is known as Hotchkiss terrible triad. Next question is, which of the following is the most common complication of Colles fracture? The correct answer is finger stiffness. Second most common is malunion. This malunion causes dinner fork deformity. Next question is, which of the following is the most commonly involved muscle of upper limb in polio? The correct answer is deltoid. Most commonly involved muscle overall is quadriceps femoris. Next question is, which of the following is the most common site of spinal trauma? The correct answer is cervical spine. But most common site of spinal fracture is lower thoracic spine. Next question is, at what level of cervical spine Hangman's fracture is seen? The correct answer is C2. This Hangman's fracture is due to hyper extension followed by distraction. There is spondylolysis of C2. There is spondylolysis of C2. At the level of C6 or C7, we can see undertaker fracture. Next question is, which of the following is not included in the triad of Klippel-Feil syndrome? The correct answer is high posterior hairline. This triad includes short webbed neck, low posterior hairline and decreased range of movement at neck. This is also known as dystrophia brevicolis congenita. There is congenital bony fusion of cervical vertebra. Next question is, which of the following nerve is involved in chiralgia parasitica? The correct answer is superficial sensory branch of radial nerve. This involvement of lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh is meralgia parasitica. Meralgia parasitica. Which layer of cornea is involved in bullous keratopathy? The correct answer is epithelium. There are 5 layers of cornea. One is epithelium, Bowman's membrane, stroma, Desmet's membrane and endothelium. These are the 5 layers of cornea. 6th layer is called as Duwa's layer. This is the strongest layer. Next question is, which of the following organism can penetrate intact cornea? The correct answer is Neisseria meningitis. The organisms penetrating intact cornea are Neisseria meningitis, Listeria, Diphtheria and Haemophilus. These are the organisms that penetrate intact cornea. Next question is, which of the following is the most common fungus infecting eyelids? The correct answer is Candida albicans. Whereas most common fungus infecting cornea is Aspergillus fumigatus. This is most common fungus infecting cornea. 35-year-old male patient complains of redness and watering of eyes. He is wearing contact lens since 5 years. What is the most likely cause for his symptoms? The correct answer is Pseudomonas infection. Most common infection in contact lens users is Pseudomonas. Soft contact lens users are also prone for developing acanthamoeba keratitis. Next question is, a 65-year-old male complains of more diminution of vision. On examination, there is corneal opacity. What is the probable diagnosis? The correct answer is nebular opacity. There are 3 types of corneal opacity. One is nebular, macular and leucoma. In nebular, there is 1/3 of stromal involvement. In macular, almost 2/3 of stromal involvement. In this whole, stroma is involved. In this question, they have given more diminution of vision. Among these 3 options, there is more diminution of vision in nebular type. In this nebular, there is only 1/3 of stromal involvement, but there is diffraction of light. That's why there is more diminution of vision than in leucoma. Next question is, which of the following is the most important factor to focus light ray on retina? The correct answer is anterior surface of cornea. Curvature of the cornea is more important factor. Next question is, which of the following is the most common complication of hypermature cataract? The correct answer is phacolytic glaucoma. What are the stages of cataract? We have lamellar separation, incipient cataract, intumescent cataract, mature cataract and hypermature cataract. The question asked is most common complication of hypermature cataract, that is phacolytic glaucoma. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट इंक्लूडेड इन द लोवे सिंड्रोम. द करेक्ट आंसर इज एंटीरियर लेंटिकोनस. लोवे सिंड्रोम इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ऑक्यूलो सेरेब्रो रीनल सिंड्रोम. This includes posterior lenticonus, glaucoma and microphakia. This anterior lenticonus is seen in Alport syndrome and in Waardenburg syndrome. Waardenburg syndrome. Which of the following is the pathognomic feature of complicated cataract? The correct answer is polychromatic luster. Most common type of complicated cataract is posterior subcapsular cataract. Osseous ring means there is iron pigments on the anterior capsule of lens. There is deposition of iron pigment. Cherry red spot means there is edema at macula. There is edema at macula. It is seen in Berlin's edema. Next question is, which of the following is the gold standard tonometer? The correct answer is Goldman tonometer. This Goldman tonometer is the example for applanation tonometer. Applanation tonometer. This is most reliable. It just touches the cornea. Tonometry means measurement of the intraocular pressure. There is measurement of intraocular pressure. Next question is, which of the following is the first line drug used in the malignant glaucoma? The correct answer is atropine. First line of drug is atropine. It causes dilatation of the pupil. So there is relaxation of ciliary muscle. So it releases the block. Next question is, which of the following drug causes nasolacrimal duct obstruction? The correct answer is timolol. Timolol is the beta blocker. It is used in the treatment of glaucoma. Which of the following alpha agonist is contraindicated in infants? The correct answer is brimonidine. Brimonidine is contraindicated in infants because it causes drowsiness and it causes CNS depression. Next question is, in which of the following condition blue sclera is not seen? The correct answer is necrotizing scleritis. In this condition, blue sclera is seen. This necrotizing scleritis is usually associated with connective tissue disorders like rheumatoid arthritis, SLE. In this blue sclera, the sclera is usually thin, so the underlying uveal tissue is visible, which appear as blue. Next question is, which of the following is not a cause for angular conjunctivitis? The correct answer is streptococcus. Angular conjunctivitis means there is conjunctivitis at the canthi with excoriation of skin. The treatment includes antibiotics and we can prescribe zinc oxide. This zinc oxide inhibits the proteolytic enzymes. Next question is, which of the following is not included in the SAFE program to control trachoma? The correct answer is excision. In this SAFE program, S means surgery, A means antibiotic, F means facial hygiene, E means environmental cleanness. Environmental cleanliness. Next question is, which of the following is the example for type 1 hypersensitivity reaction? The correct answer is vernal keratoconjunctivitis. This plictalunar keratoconjunctivitis is the example for type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. This vernal keratoconjunctivitis is also called as spring catarrh. Next question is, which of the following is the most common organism causing ophthalmia neonatorum? The correct answer is chlamydia. This ophthalmia neonatorum is usually seen in less than 1 month of baby. Chlamydia infection most commonly seen in 4 to 10 days. Chemical conjunctivitis is usually seen within 24 hours. Next question is, which of the following is the earliest feature of vitamin A deficiency? The correct answer is nyctalopia. Which of the following is not a cause for hemeralopia? The correct answer is retinitis pigmentosa. This is also called as day blindness. In retinitis pigmentosa, we will see night blindness. Next question is, which of the following sign of anterior uveitis indicates active inflammation? The correct answer is aqueous cells. This aqueous flare is due to proteins present in the aqueous humor. In this anterior uveitis, keratin precipitate is the hallmark. Next question is, which of the following is the pathognomic feature of pars planitis? The correct answer is snow banking. Snow banking means there is deposits present on the pars plana. Next question is, which of the following is not included in the Reiter syndrome? The correct answer is scleritis. Next question is, in which of the following infection, headlight in the fog appearance is seen on ophthalmoscopic examination? The correct answer is toxoplasmosis. Pigmented lesions are seen at macula. Which of the following is the first sign of sympathetic ophthalmitis? The correct answer is retrolateral flare. Which of the following is the best way to assess cephalopelvic disproportion? The correct answer is trial of labor. Trial of labor is the best way to assess CPD. It is done only in a non-scarred uterus. First, we will do trial of labor, then MRI, then CT scan. Next question is, which of the following is the most common cause of vesico-vaginal fistula in developing countries? The correct answer is obstructed labor. Most common cause of vesico-vaginal fistula in developing countries is obstructed labor. Whereas most common cause in developed countries is gynecological surgeries in developed countries. Next question is, which of the following is the most common cause of recurrent breech presentation? The correct answer is uterine anomalies. Most common cause of breech presentation is prematurity, whereas most common cause of recurrent breech presentation is uterine anomalies. Next question is, which of the following is not a criteria for external cephalic version? The correct answer is ruptured membrane. The requirements for external cephalic version are singleton pregnancy, adequate Likert, normal fetal heart rate, and there should be intact membrane. And there should be no contraindication for vaginal delivery. Next question is, neglected shoulder presentation with dead baby can be managed by all of the following methods except. The correct answer is craniotomy. Craniotomy is done only in vertex presentation. Next question is, which of the following is the investigation of choice in case of molar pregnancy? The correct answer is ultrasonography. USG is the investigation of choice, whereas for confirmation, histopathological examination is needed. Next question is, which of the following is the best sign of impending rupture of uterus? The correct answer is non-reassuring fetal heart rate. This is the first sign and it is the most common sign and it is also the best sign. Next question is, in which of the following condition induction of labor is not contraindicated? The correct answer is previous LSES. What are the contraindications for induction of labor? In all conditions in which vaginal delivery is contraindicated, there induction of labor is also contraindicated. The contraindications for induction of labor are contracted pelvis, history of ruptured uterus, transverse lie, major degree of placenta previa, classical cesarean section. Next question is, in which stage of labor there is highest risk of heart failure? The correct answer is immediate postpartum. Highest risk is seen in immediate postpartum, followed by second stage of labor, followed by after 32 weeks. Next question is, which of the following is not seen on USD in case of Hydrops fetalis? The correct answer is peritonitis. It is not seen on USD. Hydrops fetalis is seen when hemoglobin is less than 5 gram. Hydrops fetalis can be diagnosed on USG. Any of the two following features should be present: either pericardial effusion, pleural effusion, and ascites, and subcutaneous edema. Peritonitis is not present. Next question is, which of the following is the most common vessel to suffer uteroplacental insufficiency? The correct answer is umbilical artery. Ductus venosus is the last vessel to get affected. Next question is, which of the following is not the effect of increased estrogen during pregnancy? The correct answer is decreased levels of binding globulins. In pregnancy, there is increased level of binding globulins because of estrogen. Next question is, which of the following is the indication of blood transfusion during pregnancy? The correct answer is pregnancy more than 34 weeks and Hb 6 gram. What are the indications for blood transfusion during pregnancy? Any time during pregnancy, we can transfuse blood if patient is having features of impending congestive heart failure. And in case of pregnancy more than 34 weeks and Hb less than 7, in these cases also we can transfuse blood. Or pregnancy less than 34 weeks and Hb less than 5. Next question is, which of the following is the most common nerve injured in lithotomy position? The correct answer is common peroneal nerve. Most common nerve injured in peripartum or postpartum is lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh. Next question is, which of the following is not a soft marker of aneuploidy in second trimester? The correct answer is lengthy limbs. The soft markers are nuchal fold thickness, absent nasal bone, brachycephaly, and shortened limbs. Which of the following is not true about triple test? The correct answer is decreased HCG. In this triple test, there is raised HCG, decreased alpha fetoprotein, and decreased unconjugated estriol. There is something called as quadruple test. Along with these three, there is increase in inhibin. Next question is, which of the following is not a complication of polyhydramnios? The correct answer is fetal compression. This is complication of oligohydramnios. Next question is, which of the following is not the sign of placental separation? The correct answer is shortening of umbilical cord. The other options are the signs of placental separation. There is permanent lengthening of umbilical cord. There is permanent lengthening of umbilical cord. In this, there is increase in fundal height because placenta comes down and it pushes the uterus upward. Which of the following is not the correct statement about active management of third stage of labor? The correct answer is give oxytocin 10 international units IV bolus. We should give oxytocin 10 international unit as infusion. When we are giving oxytocin intravenous, we should give infusion. Oxytocin should not be given as intravenous bolus because it can cause hypotension, reflex, tachycardia, arrhythmia, myocardial ischemia, and cardiac arrest. Next question is, in which of the following case early cord clamping is done? The correct answer is when baby needs resuscitation. According to active management of third stage of labor, delayed cord clamping has to be done. That is, cord is clamped after 1 minute so that there is extra 80 ml of blood goes to baby. In some cases, early cord clamping has to be done, like in Rh negative baby and when baby needs resuscitation, and in HIV positive cases. Next question is, which of the following is not a sign of intrauterine death? The correct answer is Buddha sign. Robert sign means there is air in big vessels. It is seen as early as 12 hours. Spalding sign means there is overriding of parietal bones. This ball sign means there is hyperflexion of spine. Buddha sign means there is halo around fetal head. It is a finding of hydrops fetalis. This is not a finding of intrauterine death. Next question is, which of the following is not a diagnostic criteria of HELLP syndrome? The correct answer is elevated lipoproteins. H means hemolysis. EL means there is elevated liver enzymes. LP means there is low platelet count. HELLP syndrome is a feature of severe preeclampsia, most commonly presents in third trimester. Next question is, which of the following is the most specific gross congenital anomaly in over diabetes mellitus? The correct answer is sacral agenesis. This is also called as caudal regression syndrome. Most common CVS anomaly is ventricular septal defect. Most specific anomaly in CVS is transposition of great arteries. Next question is, what is the dose of folic acid to be given in pregnant women with high risk of gross congenital anomalies? The correct answer is 4 mg. Routinely, to prevent neural tube defects, folic acid is given in the dose of 0.4 mg. But in cases of high risk of gross congenital anomalies, the dose of folic acid is 4 mg. Next question is, which of the following is not a complication seen in baby of diabetes in pregnancy? The correct answer is hyperglycemia. In these babies, there is hypoglycemia because of hyperinsulinemia. Which of the following is true about balanced resuscitation? The correct answer is RBC, FFE, platelet to be transfused in the ratio of 1:1:1. There are two components of balanced resuscitation. First one is hypotensive resuscitation, that is BP is not targeted to maintain normal level. Second one is hemostatic resuscitation, that means blood components like RBC, FFE, platelet should be transfused in the ratio of 1:1:1. Next question is, which of the following belongs to ASA grade 5? The correct answer is moribund patients unlikely to survive without surgery. There are 6 grades of ASA. First one is normal, healthy. Second grade is patients with mild systemic disease under control. Third grade is severe systemic disease with functional limitation. Fourth grade is severe systemic disease which is constant threat to life of patient. Fifth grade is moribund patient unlikely to survive without surgery. Sixth one is brain dead patient. Brain dead patient can be taken for organ donation. Next question is, which of the following is not correct statement about adequate airway? The correct answer is thyromental distance less than 6.5 cm. These are the methods of airway assessment. Adequate airway means Malampati grade 1, thyromental distance should be more than 6.5 cm and there should be adequate mouth opening. Next question is, which of the following drug cannot be given on the day of surgery? The correct answer is insulin. Oral hypoglycemic drugs or insulin should be omitted on the day of surgery as patient will be nil by mouth, so it can lead to hypoglycemia. Next question is, which of the following gas does not require pressure reducing valve? The correct answer is cyclopropane. The pressure is around 60 psig. For oxygen and nitrous oxide, pressure will be high. So, we need to reduce the pressure to around 35 to 45. high pressure can cause pulmonary barotrauma. Next question is, which of the following is the best circuit for spontaneous ventilation? The correct answer is Maplesone A circuit. This is also called as Magill circuit. But this is inefficient circuit for controlled ventilation. This Maplesone B we are not using nowadays. Maplesone C is used for transportation. Maplesone D is best for controlled ventilation. Next question is, which of the following is not the mode of management in case of airway fire? The correct answer is continue oxygen supply through ET tube. This is not the mode of management. In case of airway fire, we need to stop the ventilation and we should remove the endotracheal tube. Turn off the oxygen and disconnect the circuit from the machine. We need to submerge the tube in water. And we should ventilate with face mask. And then re-intubate the patient and perform fiber optic bronchoscopy to assess the airway damage. We can prescribe antibiotics and steroids if necessary. Next question is, which of the following is not a contraindication for laryngeal mask airway? The correct answer is patients with difficult airway. This is one of the indication for laryngeal mask airway. Rest options are contraindication for laryngeal mask airway. Laryngeal mask airway is contraindicated in cases of full stomach patients, pregnant patients with tracheoesophageal fistula, patients with low pulmonary compliance, morbidly obese patients, and patients with oral pathology, or patients with inadequate mouth opening. Laryngeal mask airway are supraglottic devices. They form seal inside the trachea. Next question is, which of the following is not a predictor of difficult laryngoscopy? The correct answer is short upper incisors. One of the predictor for difficult laryngoscopy is long upper incisors. Next question is, which of the following is not a feature of red rubber endotracheal tube? The correct answer is radio opaque. This is wrong statement because red rubber endotracheal tube is radiolucent. Next question is, which of the following is not an indication of nasotracheal intubation? The correct answer is fracture of base of skull. This is contraindication for nasotracheal intubation. What are the other contraindications? We have CSF rhinorrhea, nasal mass, adenoids, and coagulopathy. Next question is, which of the following is the drug of choice as intravenous anesthetic in case of severe cardiovascular disease? The correct answer is etomidate. Next question is, which of the following drug causes dissociative anesthesia? The correct answer is ketamine. There is dissociation of thalamus from limbic system. Patient is conscious but unresponsive. This ketamine is given as IV or IM injection. Next question is, which of the following is the drug of choice as intravenous anesthetic in case of asthma patients? The correct answer is ketamine. This is potent bronchodilator. This ketamine is the drug of choice for full stomach patients also. Ketamine increases blood pressure and heart rate, so it also increases the myocardial oxygen demand, so it is contraindicated in hypertension and ischemic heart disease patients. Next question is, which of the following is not a component of propofol infusion syndrome? The correct answer is respiratory acidosis. This is not a component of propofol infusion syndrome. It is seen in children on prolonged infusion. It occurs due to failure of metabolism of free fatty acid. Next question is, which of the following is not a contraindication for nitrous oxide? The correct answer is abdominal surgery. It is contraindicated in surgeries involving air-containing cavity. acute intestinal obstruction is a contraindication for nitrous oxide usage. In tympanoplasty and in vitro retinal surgery, nitrous oxide is contraindicated. Next question is, which of the following route has fastest absorption rate? The correct answer is tracheal route. More the vascular site, faster the absorption, so there is shorter duration of action. In this given option, tracheal route has fastest absorption, but ideally intravenous route has highest absorption. Next question is, which of the following complication is seen in 100% cases in interscalene block? The correct answer is phrenic nerve blockade. Phrenic nerve blockade is seen in all cases in interscalene block. That is why it is contraindicated in patients with contralateral hemidiaphragmatic paralysis. Next question is, which of the following structure is not punctured during epidural anesthesia? The correct answer is arachnoid matter. Arachnoid matter is punctured during spinal anesthesia. Which of the following is not the effect of spinal anesthesia? The correct answer is increased frequency of urination. This is not seen in case of spinal anesthesia. There is sympathetic blockade, so hypotension is seen and tachycardia is seen. In case of spinal anesthesia, there is urinary retention because of blockade of detrusor muscle. High spinal anesthesia can block the cardiac sympathetic supply also, so it can cause hypotension with bradycardia also. Next question is, which of the following is not absolute contraindication for spinal anesthesia? The correct answer is hypovolemia. The other options are the absolute contraindications for spinal anesthesia, whereas severe hypovolemia is the one of the contraindication for spinal anesthesia. Next question is, which of the following is the most initial sign of malignant hyperthermia? The correct answer is masseter muscle spasm. Hyperthermia is the late sign. Malignant hyperthermia is the syndrome of rapidly rising temperature due to abnormality at rhinodine receptor. There is sustained muscular contractions. What are the triggering factors for this malignant hyperthermia? One is choline, ether, methoxyfluorine, and halothane. Next question is, which of the following drug is not given via tracheal route? The correct answer is noradrenaline. This is not given via tracheal route. What are the other drugs which we cannot give via tracheal route? We have NORAD, soda bicarbonate, calcium salt, beryllium. What are the drugs we can give via tracheal route? We have adrenaline, atropine, lignocaine, vasopressin, naloxone. Which of the following is the most sensitive indicator of myocardial ischemia in perioperative setting? The correct answer is transesophageal echo. Next question is, which of the following is the most common cause of bleeding in a patient with multiple blood transfusions? The correct answer is dilutional thrombocytopenia. Which of the following layer of epidermis contains lamellar bodies? The correct answer is stratum granulosum. Keratohyaline granules are present in stratum granulosum. These are also called as Woodland bodies or membrane coating granules. This stratum spinosum contains spinous projections. Maximum desmosomes are present in stratum spinosum. Next question is, in which of the following condition all layers of epidermis are present? The correct answer is eczema. In psoriasis and actinic keratosis, stratum granulosum is absent. stratum granulosum is absent. In very low birth weight babies, stratum cornea is absent. Next question is, which of the following is called as antigen presenting cells of epidermis? The correct answer is Langerhans cells. This Langerhans cells is also called as dendritic cells. They come from bone marrow. Dendritic cells are most commonly seen in stratum spinosum and stratum granulosum. Next question is, which of the following is the sun-induced hyperkeratotic pre-malignant disease of skin? The correct answer is actinic keratosis. Actinic means sun. This is sun-induced hyperkeratosis. After chronic exposure to sun, there is aberrant keratocytes in epidermis. It can lead to squamous cell carcinoma if untreated. Which of the following is the most common skin cancer in organ transplant patients? The correct answer is squamous cell carcinoma. Squamous cell carcinoma is the most common skin cancer in organ transplant patients, that is in immunosuppressed patients. Whereas most common skin cancer in world is basal cell carcinoma. Basal cell carcinoma is also called as rodent ulcer. Which of the following is essential for desmosome to carry out its function? The correct answer is calcium. Calcium ATPase pump is required. Any mutation in calcium ATPase pump can lead to Derrier's disease or Hailey-Hailey disease. Next question is, which of the following is the drug of choice in stage 4 acne vulgaris? The correct answer is isotretinoin. Isotretinoin is keratolytic and it is sebolytic also. This acitretin is only keratolytic. Stage 4 acne vulgaris means there is nodulocystic acne. Next question is, which of the following is used for antibiotic resistant acne? The correct answer is benzoyl peroxide. Benzoyl peroxide releases nascent oxygen, which is bactericidal. Next question is, which of the following is the most common cause of acneiform eruption? The correct answer is steroids. Acneiform eruption means drug-induced acne. Most common cause is steroids. These are monomorphic lesions. Next question is, which of the following is not correct about histopathological features of lichen planus? The correct answer is liquefactive degeneration at dermis. In lichen planus, there is liquefactive degeneration at dermo-epidermal junction. Which of the following drug is not included in Kligman regimen? The correct answer is systemic steroid. Kligman regimen is used for treatment of melasma. Brown patches are present on cheek or nose. This Kligman regimen includes topical steroid, topical retinoid, topical hydroquinone. Which of the following is not a triggering factor for rosacea? The correct answer is burns. The triggering factors are hot spicy food, exposure to sun, alcohol intake, Demodex mites, hot or cold water bath, heavy exercise. What is the treatment for this rosacea? We can prescribe oral doxycycline or minocycline, or we can prescribe oral azithromycin. Topically, we can give metronidazole. In this rosacea, topical steroids are contraindicated. This is very important because it causes telangiectasia. Next question is, which of the following is the most common cause for acanthosis nigricans? The correct answer is obesity. In acanthosis nigricans, there is black velvety areas. Usually, insulin resistance is seen. Which of the following is not the common site for nevus of Itô? The correct answer is face. There are two terminologies like nevus of Itô. This is seen on face. It is blue in color. It is unilateral and congenital, and blue sclera is seen on same side. Nevus of Itô means similar to nevus of Itô, but the site is different. Nevus of Itô is seen in shoulder, upper back and clavicular area. Next question is, which of the following is not a criteria for malignant melanoma? The correct answer is diameter of less than 6 mm. It should be more than 6 mm. What are the criteria? We have A, B, C, D and E. A means asymmetry. B means borders, that is irregular border. C means color, that is multiple colors. D means diameter of more than 6 mm. E means evolution. These are the criteria for malignant melanoma. Next question is, which of the following feature is not correct about angioedema? The correct answer is itching. Itching is not seen in angioedema because there is no itch nerve in fat, so it is usually non-itchy. What are the complications of angioedema? Respiratory edema can be seen and anaphylaxis is present. What is the treatment? We should give injection hydrocort and injection adrenaline. Next question is, in which of the following true Koebner's phenomena is not seen? The correct answer is molluscum. In this molluscum, we will see false Koebner's phenomena. This true Koebner's phenomena is autoimmune, whereas this false is viral. Next question is, in which of the following condition target lesion is seen? The correct answer is erythema multiforme. This target lesion is also called as bull's eye or iris lesion. This is seen in erythema multiforme and erythema chronicum migrans. Next question is, which of the following is not a skin feature of neurofibromatosis? The correct answer is adenoma sebaceum. This is a feature of tuberous sclerosis. This axillary freckles is the pathognomic feature of neurofibromatosis. Next question is, which of the following is not a cause of chronic telogen effluvium? The correct answer is trauma. For chronic telogen effluvium to occur, there should be chronic insult to body. These are the causes: nutritional deficiency, anemia, hypothyroidism. These are the causes for chronic telogen effluvium. Next question is, which of the following is not a feature of nail psoriasis? The correct answer is longitudinal ridge. This is seen in nail lichen planus. Salmon patch is the pathognomic feature. This salmon patch is also called as oil drop sign. Next question is, which of the following cranial nerve is the most commonly involved in Hansen's disease? The correct answer is facial nerve. Most commonly involved cranial nerve is facial nerve, whereas most commonly involved peripheral nerve is ulnar nerve. Next question is, which of the following criteria is not included in Ridley-Joplin classification? The correct answer is pathological. This is not included in Ridley-Joplin classification. It includes four criteria. One is clinical. Second one is bacteriological. Third one is histological. And fourth one is immunological. Ridley-Joplin classification is based on these four criteria. This is in leprosy. Next question is, which of the following is not true about early congenital syphilis? The correct answer is Clutton's joint. This is seen in late congenital syphilis. That means it is seen after the age of 2 years. One more important question is Hutchinson's triad. It includes interstitial keratitis, Hutchinson's tooth and eighth nerve deafness. Next question is, which of the following is the causative agent of donovanosis? The correct answer is Klebsiella granulomatosis. Chlamydia trachomatis is the causative agent for lymphogranuloma venereum. Haemophilus ducreyi is causative agent for chancroid. Treponema pallidum is the causative agent for syphilis. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos and MCQ series.